So just doing a little AM stream here for a couple hours. Working on this. Working on this character I started yesterday, which is a cyberpunk engineer. Let me pull up the concept real quick. So this is the concept. This is a cyberpunk engineer. Right. So one thing I want to do is I'm going to go ahead and pull some assets from another project where I got, where I got the hair, where I got a similar hairstyle. It's another project I kind of blocked out just to try to get. Get as much feel for the character in early as possible. Right, so let me go ahead and save this out and go to this other project. I blocked out and I do that all the time, just kind of block things out and go back to them later and whatnot. Let's see here. So I think what I want from here is maybe the hands. Go ahead and grab the hands. See, it's pretty much the same hair setup. Subtool, and I'll just save it out as a subtool into the Cyberpunk Engineer folder. Here. Should be right there. Oops. All right. She's her face still looks really funny. But let's go ahead and make that blonde. It's kind of a... There we go. Oops. Go ahead and split those hands off. Hidden mirror weld. And go ahead and position these hands. Good for now. That should be good. I really gotta do something about this face. It's killing me. Let me turn the topological off. Just gonna shape that a little better. Ponytails are much shorter. They're more like pigtails. Oops. Go ahead and grab these. Shorten them up. Them right there, and I'm going to go ahead and gotten some gravity on them. I don't really need collision volumes because they're just gonna fall. Oops, we don't got enough strength there. Come on, quick. Let's see here. We don't want to contract. Did anything happen at all? There we go. I don't know why that's so dense. It's not actually that dense of a meshes. Cloth move. Go ahead. Move those around. I guess that hair is pretty high poly. Altogether. But anyway, I don't want to spend too much time on it. Just kind of get more of the shape that's happening here. So that's that. I really gotta do some of this. All right. Go ahead and inflate this a little. Polish my features. Right. Topologically move some of them around. A little separation happening. go ahead and subdivide this with smooth modifier off. I'm just gonna, let's see here, do I, yeah, let's go ahead and with the smooth modifier off, get a little bit more topology in there. And I do want to kind of hang this, get this to hang. A little better. The hands down to the body. Oh, what did I merge here? Oh, geez. I merged to the outfit. I did not want to do that. Damn it. There we go. You know what? I'm going to have to, because I didn't want to lose the lowest subdivision level on the overalls. So let me go ahead and save this body out. Let's see, what do I need to save here? Because I don't want to do all this over again. Adding the hair and everything. So let me go ahead and, yeah, that's what I could do. I want to keep, whoa. Dagnabbit. God damn it. Let's see here. I want to, yeah. Let's see, we're keeping the eyes. We're keeping, no, we're not keeping the eyes. What are we keeping? What am I keeping here? I'm getting rid of, I just want to reload the overalls. So we want to keep all this. Yeah, we just want to keep all this. So I can delete the overalls. And we'll keep all this. Alright, I can get rid of my head measurement. And let me just go ahead and save. Just call it body. And then reopen. Here. There we go. Now we have everything. Yeah. Alright, and let me go ahead and delete all this. I do like the way the fists look better. So I'm gonna go ahead and add a subdivision to this, to the overalls. Let me go ahead and name these. Rename smooth modifier off. I'm gonna add a subdivision level and continue on. Oh yeah, and I want to add the hands to this. So let me go ahead and merge that down. Okay, cool. Let me hide the hands for the sometimes that stuff can kind of get in the way of the dynamics. I also want to keep things pretty. I kind of do want them to hang just a little better, so let me put the gravity, just do a real small iteration with just gravity. And the shoulders masked. There we go. That's kind of going to pull everything tight. And so let me grab the waist. Here. Kind of smooth that out a bit. And add the inflate. Let's see what happens. Yeah, and we're getting that little inflate going on. Just a tad. No, I don't want that. Hee hee. I put liquify on. There was another setting I saw demoed. Oh yeah, we got like firmness. But there was another setting. I'll have to look into it again, but it did something pretty cool. Let me just go ahead and run this. We don't want that much inflation, we just want it just a little more. There we go. Kinda wanted it more on the legs. You know what? Let's see what it does with contract and inflate. There we go. Snap. I don't want to hide that part of the leg. So let me run that again. Oops. I don't need to do that. Here, let me undo a couple of those. There we go. Calculate. Turn that inflate off. There we go. Just add the inflate back. And there we go. It's kind of better. That's good for the pants. I think for the top here, I'll do a contract. I'll run the contract real quick to kind of tighten that up on the back and everything. Let's see here. And we don't really want too much gravity affecting things. There we go. Contract was a little strong. Go ahead and turn it down again. probably pretty good. And I want to go ahead and mirror it. Oops. See, now maybe I don't need to mirror it. It's fine. I'm going to tuck this into the boots a little. Let's run a little polish on here. Polish my features. Real light. Real low iteration. I don't really want to go that much. There we go, that's good. Fitting a little more snug. Got the tension on the shoulders. Yeah. Gonna pull some of this back. Can pull some of this back a little. Alright, so let me go ahead and clear my mask. Need to get some anime face reference, perhaps. So I'm guessing on this character the eyes are probably going to be pretty big, going by the shape of the head. Split those eyebrows off. Surface plane happening where they're supposed to. Hey Ray, how you doing? Yeah, I like to do anime characters. I'm actually doing this this cyberpunk engineer, cuz I'll just be able to yeah, just get into a lot more stuff I do in ZBrush, you know, on something like this. So I kind of shelved the Raven Girl. I'm gonna work on Raven Girl offline a little more, and then probably come back in with her on the when I get closer to rendering. So when I get closer to finishing up the final render and everything. So, but the, yeah, but this I could probably get done in a couple hours, streaming a couple hours for the next couple weeks. So, I just kind of wanted to better focus my efforts. Yeah, there's quite a bit of work. Yeah, there's quite a bit of work left on that. Mostly polish work. And I'm finding it, like, in the stream, it's kind of hard to get into polish work the way I need to. So, I'll do a lot of polish with it offline and then, like, come back in to show some of the substance and rendering stuff when it's closer to final. Yeah, it's not the most fun part, and yeah, it's just gonna be me like just like tweaking a bunch of little stuff and it's like the hardest part. So I think with this I should be able to show most of the process pretty much from start to finish. I can start blocking out some of these pieces. And what I'm gonna do is duplicate the overalls and work on that and delete the highest subdivision level on it. Overalls, blocking out. That's what I'm doing now. All right. So the cool thing is we got all this, you know, we got pretty nice topology to work with to go ahead and start extracting out some of the accessories. So we've got this little pouch in the middle here. And again, I'm working on a duplicate for that. Here in the middle, go ahead and extrude with polygroup all. I'm going to do the control extrude for that, pull it out just a little, and then we got this other long pouch right here, same thing, and that's control extrude with polygroup all on. And what else do we have? See, we can get a little shape for our knee, our little knee armor. Oops. And then we got the little pouch above it. Probably ain't gonna worry about the straps yet. And it looks like there's actually some kind of leg support. Yeah, some type of leg support system related to these straps, and it runs all the way down here. I wish I could see it from the side, but that'll just be an area where I'll just kind of have to wing it. I'm still not sure what this thing is wrapped around her. I mean, it looks like a jacket. That looks like sleeves of a jacket. But where's like the rest of the jacket, you know? So, I don't, you know, that'll be a little difficult, you know, in terms of what I should do there. Maybe, you know, I don't know what that is. I always hate stuff like that, but there's always something like that, you know, when you model from these concepts. It's always best to kind of find front and back if you can, but, you know, whatever. I'll be able to figure something out for that. Yeah, there's a ton of stuff to model. That's kind of like my wheelhouse, I guess. You know, I've done a lot of this pouch modeling over the years, so I'm pretty familiar with it. What do you think this thing is around her waist here? You think that's a jacket? I mean, that looks like sleeves, but it's hard to tell. You know, just some kind of rag, because where's the back of it? You know, or, you know, I might just be able to make it into a jacket. Could always just do that. But yeah. Yeah, it is. It is a bit strange. And I could just go ahead and assume it's a jacket. You know what? Yeah, it might be just some type of like sleeves, you know, like a really short jacket that just kind of, I've seen those before. It's basically just sleeves, and they kind of go around the arms and just drape over like part of the chest a little bit. Yeah, something along those lines. And it's not like a full, like the jacket doesn't cover her, you know, it's not a long jacket. It's like, let me see if I got that little pen app. I did have that pen app. Oh, there it is. So I'm thinking, like, let me change the color here. Undo. How do I control? So I was thinking it might. Be something like this. And it's just like a sleeve to protect her arm when she's working. So I'm thinking it could be something like that. Oh, maybe. Maybe. Oops. So what do you think? You think it could be something like, just like a sleeve, like, kind of like that? And then Yeah, maybe she like, I don't know. And she just like unzipped it here and then, you know, pulled her arms out of it and it just kinda, you know what I'm saying? Like if she were to have this on her waist, she could just slip her arms into it and then like kinda pull it up. I'm thinking something like that. Yeah, it can pretty much be anything. So yeah, I guess it's an area where I can, you know, kind of fill in the blanks. Stuff. I guess that's it for the little pockets and everything. And I actually have buckles I can use too. I have some buckle insert meshes that I can repurpose for the buckles. And so yeah, I can go ahead and I'm gonna take a little break and then I'll get started fleshing out these pouches. Let me go ahead and get them on their own subtool. I can go ahead and turn that off for now. And I will be back in about 5. Alright, I am back. Oops. There we go. I don't think the music's that loud. But yeah, I'm probably gonna stay on till about 8. Because I actually got an art test I need to finish up this week. So I gotta get on that, and I've got some other work I need to do today. So here we are. Let's see here. I guess I could just start by moving some points around. Yeah, they still do them. Yeah, I mean, yeah, most game studios here in the U.S. they pretty much do them all the time. Like, I don't think they're. You know what? I don't think the art tests are as prominent in figurines, because I've done some work in figurines too, and I didn't have an art test for it. But games, yeah, especially the bigger studios. If you know someone at the company, like, you know, I think that may change things a little bit. Like, if they've worked with you and they know you, you know. They like, no, okay, we know this guy, you know, can work in our pipeline and all that. So I think in that situation you may not, but I've seen some really like superstars get art tests, you know, where they did know, you know, they actually knew someone at the studio and they're quite known. And I just remember them making a post on Facebook about it, you know, like an art test, really. But it was for Naughty Dog. The artist was like, Naughty Dog had offered them a position, but they still wanted him to take an art test. So, yeah. Do they not do that in France? They don't do the art test once you have a portfolio and experience. And maybe film doesn't do it, you know, I don't know. All right. It's actually quite a bit wider. Oops, let me turn topological and go to polygroups. Actually, no, you seem about right. Go ahead and cut these down a little. Let me go ahead and polygroup all of them. No, they pretty much do them for everybody. As far as I know, I haven't, you know, I don't think for everybody. Like I said, like, if you've worked with people at the studio and it's kind of like one of those situations, and, you know, someone you work with goes into a studio and they're looking for somebody, and they've worked with that person, so I think I think it all depends. I think there is some discretion with them. I mean, they may, you know, I think, yeah, maybe if you work in a similar style, like if you went, say, from one of the Call of Duty studios to what's the ones who do Battlefield? Just as an example, I think if, you know, you worked on Call of Duty a lot or something like that, and you went to who is it? I forget who does Battlefield, but yeah, maybe a situation like that, you know, you probably, I mean, I'd be surprised in a situation like that if they administered an art test, because it's pretty much the same stuff. Or maybe a situation from like Blizzard to Riot, you know. Like if you were at Blizzard and you were gonna go to Riot and you spent like 3 to 5 years at Blizzard, I mean, I'd be surprised. I mean, if it happened to me, I'd be like, "Are you what? Be like, are you kidding me? Really?" So. That's pretty good. Those shapes. Couple edge loops here. That's a little knee pad. Let's go for the for any flaps like that, I like to go ahead and make them their own piece as well. Sometimes I just bevel them, but I kind of like having the control of like flipping and bending the edges, you know, kind of like, you know, kind of get that kind of fidelity. So I'll actually separate them. Let's see, I got them all, and this one kind of has a different shape to it. This one pouch right here kind of has that little bevel shape in there. Bevel this down so we get that, get a nice corner. It wraps. Thickness. These are actually a little thick right now, but that's all right. Yeah, that's actually kind of has a peak to it. Right. this little thing kind of bends in on itself. Go ahead and get that. That happening. Nancy is raiding. What's raiding? What does raiding mean? With a party of one. Hey, Delancey. Oh, Delan Clay. What's the whole raid thing? Is that like if you're gaming? Is that more of like a game thing? Because I've never gamed on Twitch. Like I'm totally new to Twitch, just with the stream here. This is like my first time. I actually might do some gaming though. I might play Disgaea 5. I might stream that a little bit at some point. Oh, cool. Oh, that's awesome. Thanks. Appreciate that. Yeah, I'm almost at, I got right about 30 subs or followers. I got about 30 followers. 20 away from 50. But I haven't had an average of 3 viewers. I haven't done that yet. But yeah, they set the bar pretty low, so I'm guessing overall it's pretty hard to really get things popping on your stream. And I also have Oh, so are you fairly new too? How long have you been going at it? And I'm also streaming out to YouTube too, so that way all my videos get archived and they're not muting my audio. I've already had a couple videos where they muted the audio, but I'm using copyright free music. They still muted some audio a couple times. I don't know if I can contact them to be like, hey, look, I'm using copyright free music. Yeah, I like streaming here better. But I'm pretty much using the YouTube, so all my videos are archived and saved. Yeah, but I am using a copyright free music, you know, so I don't know what their deal is. Oh, did you get hit with a mute? Was there any way to resolve it? Oh, okay. Can you save the streams here? I thought they only saved them for, I think, 14 days. And then they delete them. Where can you save them, like fully archive them? Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm super new too. Yeah, because there's no real discretion with what they mute. I think it's just a bot that does it, and I don't even know, you know, what it actually, how it thinks, like, oh, you know, like, what's its criteria for assuming something's copyrighted? You know, they need to fix that. They need to update it or something. All right, man. Yeah, thanks for stopping by. Thanks for the raid support. Much appreciated, man. Yeah, I'm probably gonna get off here in about 20 minutes anyway. I actually got a bunch of shit I gotta do today. But yeah, man, thanks for stopping by. Straps happening on this top one, and actually they're kind of short and hanging, so I don't need to take them all the way down. Those off. Oh no, we don't want back face. Actually, on this one, the bottom kind of is rounded, so what I'll do is add an edge loop, bevel it, and shift extrude that out. There. Kind of get that more pouchy look. And it's the same with this one up here. This, let's see. Probably add an edge loop in here and go ahead and move with auto. And then I can just use move infinite radius and just kind of slide that up. And move it in. Kind of like that. Alright. Right. Let's go ahead and add pants are kind of like a grayish blue. Go ahead and get that color in there. Oh, what did I do? These actually might need to be a little lower. Knee pads and this pouch. We can go ahead and get some of these belts. Duplicate this again because I did make some changes. Make sure we have the most. All right, so for this belt, we'll just go ahead. Oh, we got subdivision levels on that. Just go ahead and bevel that out. So yeah, I'm creating these. I'm gonna go ahead and get these straps in here. And then probably rework the dynamics a little bit for the straps. All right. This one's fine, I can just polygroup that. See, we have three, and then we have one right here. I want to say yeah, this is probably it right here. Let me go ahead and make them all the same polygroup. Tension from them in there. Just do this. Got that nice little. And then them off. Go ahead and split them. And that should be all right for that for now. Oops. Go ahead and auto-loop all this stuff. Yeah, and like for these little straps that hang and stuff. I usually like to just to go shift extrude them to move them in a little and then extrude them out so they're just closer to the surface. Alright. Go ahead and move this into place. So that's what we have going on there. And actually this is actually a strap on the overall, so let me go ahead and do the same thing. We'll get a couple edge loops in here. Polygroup on this, and then add a little edge loop here and here. And kind of the same idea. Shift extrude to just kind of get that surface change from where this clothing would, you know, get the tension in there for the clothing there. It's kind of the idea. Right. I'll go ahead and extrude that off. Right about there. I'll go ahead and break it off. Alright. And I'll probably delete that later, like the or whatever. Or I may make this all one mesh again, you know. Kind of do like a watertight mesh for the overalls when it's retopologized and everything. Thanks, Grimsy, and welcome to the stream, man. Thanks for stopping by. Yeah, I'm working on this cyberpunk engineer character. So yeah, it just looked like a lot of fun to model and sculpt, you know. Probably a lot more modeling. You know, I get to show the dynamics quite a bit with this and just other things in ZBrush. Got a lot of cool stuff happening. It's just, this kind of stuff is just kind of fun to model. Yeah, man, just keep working at it, you know. In situations where I've learned the most, it's usually like I try to do like project focused learning. So either you find a subject matter you really like, or you don't like, or just looks interesting to make, or a character concept, and definitely lots of reference and lots of anatomy. Let's see here, like the Anatomy for Sculptors book is really good reference for anatomy, because it really shows you the breakdown of the volumes. You know, it shows you everything. It has scan data, and then they paint, you know, he does a lot of illustrations over the scan data and break in kind of volumized breakdowns of the shapes, which is like really helpful for learning how to see it in 3D. And it's just practice, man. Just lots of practice. Let me see if I can pull up the... pull up that. So yeah, I use this since I've got it quite a bit. This is the, they have a digital version on their website as well as the paperback. But yeah, you see like how it, you know, how they go through and break down like these shapes, these volumes, you know, and there's just a lot of information. You know, they have a fat pad guide. I mean, pretty much the whole body is broken down. So yeah, that's a great book if you're, you know. It's a great book to kind of help you to really start seeing all the forms and everything. So I got left to block out on this on the clothing here. Maybe I'll wait on the arms. I can go ahead and get. No, I gotta. Yeah, definitely check it out. Oops. We actually want to move topological. Something's still funny about these arms for me. scale these out a little more. Good. That. Go ahead and make this strap thing hanging out. And split that, and then I'm actually gonna undo that because I don't wanna keep all that the way it is. Go ahead and move this out. So we have that little strap. Go ahead and finally get some color in here. It's kind of like a red. All right. And that is going to be it for me. I'm probably going to come back on a little later, probably sometime this afternoon, for a little while. I actually got work I need to get on today, so thanks for watching. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I will check y'all later. Peace.